For months, youth have been mobilizing for an anti-corruption march to parliament on social media amid anger over long-running allegations of corruption involving several high-profile public officials, including the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, who has rejected calls for her resignation.
Corruption. We plaza don't block. We are fighting for you. We are tired of corruption.
We are tired of corruption. We are tired of theft. We are tired of everything as Gen Z's. Anita must go.
Police previously announced that they had not permitted the march and would not allow any demonstration that threatened Uganda's peace and security. This was reiterated by President Yoweri Museveni during his address to the nation, terming the planned demonstrations as playing with fire. However, on Tuesday, a handful of youth tried to walk to Parliament in protest that authorities deemed illegal. Security forces deployed heavily in various parts of Kampala where small groups of protesters had gathered. Police roughed up some campaigners, foiling the much anticipated march to Parliament. Over 30 protesters were arraigned in court on charges of idle and disorderly and being a common nuisance. They pleaded not guilty and were ordered to return to court on different dates between July 30th and August 6th. Soon after this, on Thursday, President Museveni released a press statement hailing the security forces for foiling the protests. In his statement, Museveni stated that there were bad foreign elements who had instigated youth to protest. He warned against foreigners who he said were meddling in internal affairs to destabilize Uganda and that he had proof. According to the president, the foiling of the demonstrations was a highly intelligence-led operation with credible information that will shock the court during the trial of the suspects. On the same day, the head of the State House Investors Protection Unit, Colonel Edith Nakalima, also held a meeting with the youth leaders and discussed how they can fight corruption in the country through the right procedures. During the same meeting, the National Youth Council of Uganda chairperson, Jacob Eyeru, requested Nakalima to engage the president on the issue of those who were arrested on Tuesday as they tried to march to parliament.
Afande, I have looked at some of the charge sheets and the cases preferred against them. And some of them have been declared before unconstitutional. The president has commented on them, some of them. However, my prayer for coming here is for two reasons. One is that those events were not beautiful to see for those young people. Some of them maybe were acting out of conviction, others for whatever reason, but many of them remain young people. And my prayer here today is that we request you, as the chief fighter of corruption after the president, to help us ask the president to pardon those young people. Let them not stay in jail because of a fight of conviction on corruption.
Colonel Nakalima assured the youth leaders that the arrested protesters would be set free. She further rallied the youth to continue fighting corruption in the country, but in an organized manner.
So if you want to make a positive change, you must follow the right procedures. You must do the needed verification. You must follow the law and what it demands. So, in this whole explanation, I'm trying to say that the youth are supposed to show their dissatisfaction with the thought of what is being done. Yes, we are all, meanwhile, all of us are not satisfied that corruption is handled the way it should. That's why, again, His Excellency the President and our Commanding Chief, on a daily, he is either directing for more efforts in the fight against corruption, warning the public against corrupt tendencies, but achieving the elimination of corruption.
The Uganda youth protests against corruption were partly inspired by demonstrations last month in neighboring Kenya, which forced President William Ruto to drop planned tax rises.